Well, today I'm talking to Kathryn Williams, a National Geographic Kids editor, and we're talking, hold that book up, Weird But True, World 2023. There we go. I was reading some of the reviews already out, and what a fun book this sounds like. I mean, the world is a wild place to explore, isn't it?
It is. It's full of all kinds of weird stuff, places, animals, people.
And you take middle schoolers on a little a journey across all seven continents. Now, the thing with National Geographic is they've always got the most beautiful photography, right? It just kind of it enhances the story.
Yeah, we love showing kids, you know, the pictures of real things in the world out there. And our photographs in this book are really awesome and stunning. I mean, they range from photos of giant crystals that are beautiful to kind of wacky festivals of people wrestling in mashed potatoes and snorkeling through bogs and things like that. So there's all kinds of photos in this, and they're all weird and wonderful.
Yeah, this was the kind of book I was reading when I was a kid. I was so happy to see this. So the wackiest festival, you cover the wackiest festivals. What are some of the wackier festivals in the world?
Oh, there's all kinds of fun ones. I'm partial to bog snorkeling in the United Kingdom and Wales.
And what is that? What is that?
So people put on a snorkel and flippers and a mask, and they dive into a bog. And so they're in this, you know, muddy water, and they're trying to go as fast as they can. And some of them wear costumes, dressed like sharks or dinosaurs. And then there's a separate portion of this competition where people actually bike while snorkeling in the bog. So they're in a bike in the water snorkeling. And it's just very funny.
How fun.
Yeah.
You cover strange animals. I know kids love that too. Some of the strangest animals that you can think of. Do you have a favorite?
Yeah, one of my favorites is the hairy frog, which is called a hairy frog because it's got all these like little skin flaps that look like hair along the side of its body. But it's also weird because it has these little bones in its fingers that it can kind of pop through its skin like Wolverine, like the X-Men.
Yeah.
And it's nicknamed the Wolverine frog, so it can use these little claws to defend itself that come out of its hands.
That's very crazy. You know, I'm a certified diver, and so I can't wait to get the book because you do a whole thing on the ocean.
Yes, we have a chapter on stuff under the sea, and we have a chapter we do sea in space. So we have stuff in space, and there's a lot of cool diving stuff throughout the book. I mean, there's a place in Iceland that we feature that you can dive between continents, between like tectonic plates,
and saw that.
Touch each continent while you're underwater. Like, yeah, that is so cool.
The water's like crystal clear or something.
Yes,
right?
it's absolutely pristine water. And so we have this like photo of a diver between the two continents. It's very cool.
How did you get into all this, Kathryn? Like, how did you come to edit the book and kind of compile it, and it's become an annual thing now, right?
Yeah, so this is the first book, and it's going to be an annual series. So we're going to get new content and update content every year. There's a lot of weird stuff in the world, so hopefully we'll have enough to go on and on. But yeah, it's a lot of our books are a brainchild of like a lot of people. It kind of takes a village. And so we had this kind of idea to do this annual book. We have our Weird But True series that we've been doing forever. That's these smaller books that have fun facts in them. And we said, okay, why not take this and make it like way bigger and do the world? Because National Geographic, we love to show people the world, and we just haven't done it yet with this Weird But True style. So we have a team of writers that worked on this, photo editors who pick out all the great photos, we have designers. It takes a lot of people.
So how do you figure out what's weird enough for a middle schooler?
It's tough. It's really tough. And it's a lot of pressure, you know, relatively, not like a surgeon or a rocket scientist, but it's a lot of pressure to kind of say what's definitively weird for everyone. Yeah. So what we're doing, like, because this book is around the world, we're trying to find things that are weird for everyone, no matter like where they're living, to some extent. So we're looking for things that are like rare, things that are one of a kind, Middle school kids love like a gross out factor, so we have a little bit of that. Things like getting muddy, we have, you know, like kind of gross animals, stinky animals, things like that.
What caught my eye was the underwater post office. Okay, where is it and what is it?
Yeah, as a diver, that I'm sure there's so many places underwater to explore. So this is the underwater post office. It's functional in Vanuatu, which is a country, an island kind of off of Australia. And you have to get a waterproof postcards to mail there. So it's a little inconvenient, but it's great to say, hey, I received a postcard from an underwater post office.
Yeah, just it's a cool little collectible, you know. I who would have even thought? I would love to see how that whole thing works. I can't wait to get the book. So you've got also this weird category, because you know there's weirdos, right? So it's the top weirdos in three categories. How did you decide who would make that cut?
I mean, yeah, this was another thing. It's pretty subjective, but we had a lot of discussions as an editorial team with the photo director, the writers, and to kind of decide which things we would deem, you know, this year are the weirdest. And then we can take the ones that we didn't make it and look at them again for next year. But we have weird places, weird animals, and weird photos, which are very cool and fun to argue. The staff can argue about which photo they think is the weirdest.
When it comes to National Geographic, like I said, that's what I remember as a kid, just getting the book, the adult book, you know, and just going through it and just reading and reading and looking at all the photos of all the places all over the world. This book has maps, it's got personality quizzes, there's photo spreads, it's stats. It's for that kid that's really curious, just really curious, wanting to learn more. Another thing that caught my eye was that underground amusement park.
Yeah.
Where was that?
So that is, where is that?
It's
in Romania.
Where is it? Romania.
Romania. Okay. This place is pretty cool. It's an underground, entertainment area. It's got a Ferris wheel, a playground, a bowling alley, all kinds of stuff. It's in an abandoned mine. So that's why it's underground. And the history is very interesting. It used to be, in World War II, it was used as a bomb shelter. And then in the 1950s, it was used as a cheese warehouse. And now you can go bowling there. So it's kind of a funny lifetime.
You know, we talked about the hairy frog, okay? But mm-hmm. what's the strangest thing that you've ever seen or that kind of just like blew your mind?
Oh my goodness. I don't know if I can answer the strangest thing. There was one thing, and I think this is not in this book, but it's in our next edition, so you'll have to wait.
I
was looking through photos of animals and there was this bird that it had like six legs.
Oh, wow.
Or eight legs. And I was looking at it and I was like, I've never seen a bird like this. And it kind of broke my brain. And then I was reading some articles about it. It's a bird that sticks its babies under its wings and carries them. And all that you can see from the babies is these legs sticking out.
Oh,
so
that's wild.
That photo, and I don't find a lot of things because, you know, I've been doing this for like over 7 years now. And I'm like, oh, otters hold hands to keep from floating away. That's boring. I've seen that fact, you know, things that other people think are weird at this point. I'm kind of like, oh, I've seen it a million times. And then that photo of the bird with all the legs kind of blew my mind.
That's why you should be editing these, because you've seen all the weirdness. You can, with a middle schooler, you're going to be able to know exactly what they're into. But why do you think National Geographic does this? I mean, I think it's great. I think it's great to expose young kids to the world. It's not like they can just, you know, grab their passport and start traveling. But as a little kid, it can kind of light that fire under them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, there's so many different reasons. First, like, we think these books, which are super engaging and easy for kids to dive in and out of, is a nice accessible way to get them to learn about the world and maybe care for it and take care of it. And also, it shows them what's out there. I mean, I didn't know that, you know, you could be you know, a volcanologist who studies, you know, lava and climbs volcanoes and things like that. I didn't know, you know, all these places around the world that people are studying. I mean, in the book, we even have that scientists found a rainforest in 2018 on top of a mountain in Africa that people hadn't discovered yet. So there's still things to discover. There's still things left to do in the world, weird things left to find. And I think the more kids know what's out there, the more they'll want to be part of that.
Yes. Yes. You got it. You got to understand it before you can be of assistance and help with it. Right.
Okay. Yeah.
So I read, I know I only got you for a couple more minutes. I read that you're into like creepy crawly kind of like bugs and snakes. Yeah. So I'm going to give you in a scenario. So let's say that I just want to see how you think. So let's give you in a scenario. You're in your apartment or your house, and there's a fly flying around, right? And he lands on the screen. What do you do?
I don't know. I probably would shoo it away. I don't know if I would.
Yeah, I'm crazier than you because I get a tissue. It's like they know I'm coming to them, you know, to rescue them. I get a tissue, you know, I grab them. They just stay there. I lift up the screen.
Really?
Yes.
Maybe I'm not confident enough. I need to do that.
Really? It really is like they know, like there's some kind of, they know, okay, she's going to not kill me. You know, I was in the pool a couple of days ago and there was I was doing laps and I swam by the filter and I thought I saw something in there and I pushed it down and grabbed it out and it was a little frog, right? A little frog that somehow, you know, I put him down on the cement. Off he goes. A little later, a grasshopper lands in the pool. I like you. I like you.
Yes.
I love the insects and everybody has a purpose, right?
Yes, they're fun. I do often find bugs kind of on me. I'm like,
it's the vibe. It's the vibe you're sending out. Hey, Kathryn Williams, National Geographic's kids editor, talking weird. Hold it up. Weird but true world 2023. It's available at your local bookstore, online, everywhere. Where can people reach out to you?
You can find us on nationalgeographickids.com for like cool info about animals and stuff like that, and our books. And yeah, you can find our books online and at brick and mortar retailers.
Well, I can't wait to talk to you again. So thank you so much for your time and conversation today, Kathryn.
Thank you so much.
Have fun.
All right.